Olumi here. So if you're new here, then thanks for dropping in by my channel. You are more than welcome to my channel. So today what we are going to do is we are going to achieve this vertigula makeup look over here. And for the base makeup look, what you need to do is you just need to head on to my IGTV. My Insta handle is polumimimi. From there you can check out my IGTV where I have done this entire base makeup routine. And for this particular eye makeup routine, you need to keep on watching this entire video. And if you really enjoy watching this entire video, please consider subscribing to my channel and liking this video, and maybe share it with your loved one, family, friends, girlfriends, except whoever you want to share it with. So now, without any more further blabbering and wasting of your valuable time, let's roll the intro. I'm totally done with my base makeup, and I have also prepped and primed my eyelids. And to prep and prime my eyelid, I have used my all-time favorite, that is the PAC Spotlight Cherry Concealer, which is basically this one. It is in the shade 0.5 porcelain. I just love using this particular concealer over here. So I have used this concealer to set my eyelids, like to prep my eyelids. And then I have slightly dust up some loose powder, and to do that I have used my K-Beauty HD Translucent Loose Powder. It is in the shade white. It is a translucent loose powder, as you can see from here. So I have used this particular powder over here to slightly dust up the area. So right now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start off with my eyeshadow palettes. And the palettes that I'm mainly going to use for today's look are going to be these palettes by Colourpop Cosmetics. As you can see, like, these are the three palettes by Colourpop Cosmetics. I love using Colourpop Cosmetics palettes. So the very first palette that I'm going to start on with right now is going to be this beautiful palette over here, which is known as Just My Luck. So I'm just going to take this beautiful palette over here, and from this beautiful palette I'm just going to take this beautiful shade, which is basically this one over here. So I'm just going to take this beautiful shade over here called Act Natural, and I'm just going to start putting it onto my crease. So now at this point, as you can see, that I'm done putting on that dark green shade. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm just going to go towards another palette, and from that particular palette I'm just going to take some light green shade. And taking that light green shade, what I'm going to do is I am just going to blend this dark green shade with that light green shade. So that is what I'm going to do. And to do that, the palette that I'm going to take is going to be my Morphe X James Charles palette, which is basically this one. And from this particular palette over here, I'm taking this light green shade, which is basically this one. So taking this shade over here, I'm just going to start blending that dark green shade. Now at this point, when you can see that I'm totally done with those two green shades, like the dark green shade and blending it out with the light green shade. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm just going to go towards the next color. And for the next color, today I'm going to take my Blue Moon palette by Colourpop Cosmetics. And taking this beautiful palette over here, I'm going to take this beautiful shade, which is known as Clubbed In, which is basically this one. So I'm just going to take this beautiful shade over here. And taking this beautiful shade, I'm just going to extend this a dark green shade with this dark blue shade. So that is what I'm going to do right now. And I'm not only going to extend that shade, but I'm just going to draw like a curved S sort of a thing onto like this area. So that is what I'm going to do right now. So I'm just going to slowly curve this blue shade, and I'm just going to take it towards like my hairline, as I prefer doing these days. I'm not concentrating on blending this shade, this blue shade right now. I'm just drawing the outline, and I am just, you know, trying to keep the intensity of this particular blue shade. So now, as you can see, that I'm done putting on that dark blue shade called Clubbed In. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm just going to start blending the dark blue shade with some light blue shade. And to do that, the shading shade that I'm going to take right now is going to be this shade called Sturdy Eye. and I'm slightly going to mix it with this sheet called fine china. So I'm just going to take like a mixture of these two sheets right now, and I'm just going to blend that. Yeah, I think the mixture is looking pretty good. So I'm just going to start blending on that dark blue sheet called Club 10. So now as you can see that I'm done with the first wave where I have put on green and blue and blended it out. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm just going to cut my crease. But before going on towards my cut crease, I'm just going to take my eye makeup remover. You can take any eye makeup remover of your choice, or you can take a micellar water, anything that saves your boat, and a Q-tip. I am just going to clean in this area so that I can get a nice and clean cut crease. So now as you can see that I'm done removing that base from my eyelid area. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take my concealer, the concealer which I use to prep and prime my eyelid, and I'm just going to take that concealer and I'm just going to start cutting my crease. Now as you can see that I'm totally done with the cut crease. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go back towards my Morphe Exchange Shots palette, and from this particular palette over here I'm going to take this white shadow which is like this big fan. So I'm just going to start putting this color onto like this particular little portion of my eyes. So now as you can see that I'm done with that white shade and putting it onto like this area, like halfway towards my eyeball. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take my Blue Moon palette, and from this particular palette over here, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this beautiful shade which is known as Tight Pull, which is a bit like a shimmery shade. So I'm just going to take this beautiful shade over here and I am just going to start putting it onto like this leftover portion of my eyes. So now at this point, when you can see that I'm done with that shimmery blue shade and putting it onto like this particular area of my eyes, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to repeat the process of my cut crease. So I'm just going to again start cutting my crease. So first I'm going to start with taking my eye makeup remover onto another brush, and I'm just going to start cutting my crease, like cleaning that area, and then obviously I am just going to go ahead with my concealer to cut my crease. So now at this point when you can see that I'm done with that cut crease, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take my Orange You Glade palette, which is basically this one. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this shade over here called Mimosa Mummy, which is basically this one. So I'm just going to take this beautiful shade over here, and to shade this shade further, I'm going to take this shade over here which is known as Sunkissed. Then maybe I'm just going to blend it with this particular shade over here which is known as Zested. So I'm just going to go like 1, 2, and then 3. They're like, these are going to be my order in which I will be going. So yeah, I'm starting with the shade called Mimosa Mummy which is over here, and I'm just going to start putting it onto the innermost portion of my eyes. Now going towards that lighter orange shade called Sunkissed which is over here. So now as you can see that I'm done putting on those two orange shades and blending it out. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go towards that shimmery blue shade which is basically this one. So now taking this particular shade over here onto the same brush, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to like, you know, put a draw a nice winged liner onto like this area of my eyes so that I know I can put on like a demarcation with the oranges ending over here. So now now as you can see that I'm done putting on that blue shade, like onto like as a liner, as a, you know, as a straight line onto like this area. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go back towards that shade called Mimosa Mummy, and I'm just going to take the shade over here, and then I'm going to shade it with this one. So I'm just going to take these two shades and I'm just going to blend it like onto like this area a little bit. I'm just taking a tad bit of this shade and I'm just, you know, blending this outer portion onto this my hairline. So now at this point when I'm almost done with all the shades and doing my entire eye, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go behind the camera, put on some falsies and some mascara, and I will be just completing the other eye as I did this eye. So I'm just going to be back in a... So now I'm back after putting on my falsies and some mascara and completing the other eye. So this is how my makeup turned out to be after like doing the entire look. So for my falsies today, I'm wearing some falsies from Amazon, which are basically this one. I will be linking everything down below in the description box, so do not worry about that. I highly recommend these falsies. These are like so good. And for my mascara today, I'm wearing my NYX Wota Hype mascara, which is basically this one. It actually Wota Hype. And on my lips today, I'm wearing my NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream, which is in the shade Los Angeles. So this is the lip shade which I'm wearing on my lips. I am just loving how this look turned out to be. I'm so grateful and so thankful to all of you for joining in and watching this entire video. I hope to see you guys in the next video. Till then, take care, keep it glam, and love you all as always.